Hi, this is James Roney from First Choice College, and in this video we're going to talk about geography, or where in the country would you like to go to school. We're going to break geography into two pieces. The first piece is where in the country, so location, and the second piece is what type of setting for the school. Do you want to go to a school in a small city or a big city? Do you want to go to school in a suburb? Do you want to go to school in a more rural area? Those are the two pieces we're going to look at when we talk about geography. So first, we're going to talk about you, your personal preferences. A lot of times when I talk to high school students, there are two places they want to go to college. One, as close to home as possible, and two, as far away from home as possible. So just thinking about those things. If you want to go to school on the other side of the country or far away, how far away? Are you going to be okay if the only way to get home is a plane ride? And if maybe does that mean then that you're only going to be coming home over the long breaks, right? Over whether it's spring break or more likely maybe just the semester break in between the fall and spring semesters. Do you need access to public transportation? You only want to be a train ride, a plane ride, or a bus ride away from home? Are there any family obligations that mean that you can't go that far? This is a family decision, college. So are your parents going to need you home to help out with grandparents or a younger sibling? Do you want to be able to see your parents once in a while? Do you want to be only a car ride away so that if you needed them, they could be there if you were sick? If you needed to go home for a weekend once in a while, you can do so. Or do you want to be very close to home? Are there certain things? Do you have a job at home, or again, family obligations that you need to be able to get home regularly? How long have you stayed away from home in the past? If you want to go to school on the other side of the country, have you been away for more than a week at a time? How has that gone? This is a place where summer programs are a great test run. Doing maybe a summer program on a college campus the year before you go away to make sure, what's it like being away from home for 3 weeks or 4 weeks, and how do you do in that situation? Are you ready for climate changes? If you live in the South and you're going up north, you'll need to add a lot of sweaters into your wardrobe. So, have you thought about that? Personal preferences. Are there any things, hobbies, that you need to be near that put restrictions on the geography? Do you like to go skiing in the winter? Do you need to be near a mountain? Or are you going to be okay if you can just go skiing when you go home over the winter break? Do you like surfing? Again, are you going to be okay if you only go surfing on the breaks, or do you want to have access to an ocean when you're there? So are there other things that will influence the setting of the school? For instance, do you have an interest in live theater? Do you want to be near an urban area that has plenty of cultural opportunities, things off the campus? So museums, whether it's an opera that you can go to, symphony, live theater, are there plenty of those opportunities around? Next, talking about the academics, how do the academics influence where you should go to school? So do you have a major that requires you to be in a certain area? Are you thinking of marine biology, so you know you need to be near an ocean? Are you thinking of an agricultural major, so that you would need to be in a rural area? Internships. Are you thinking of majoring in journalism or communications? Do you need to be in a media market that has plenty of internships available at television stations or radio stations? Do you want to go into tech? Do you want to go into finance or accounting? So do you want to be near a city with a lot of companies that have the opportunities for you to get internships? And you can always do internships at home over the summer, but sometimes the location of the school will help. There may be a lot of internships there, or there may be companies that have great relationships with colleges, so it's a pipeline for you, so something to consider. Another thing to consider is, where do you want to live after college? Do you want to come back home, so you want to use college as your opportunity to try living in a different area of the country? Or do you know that you want to get into tech, so you want to be near Silicon Valley so that you can have a pipeline there? Or that you want to get into government relations, so you want to go to college in D.C. so you have an opportunity to build connections in D.C. so you could stay there after college. So again, thinking of this in personally, you know, where are you going to be happy? Because college is, if you're going away to live on campus, if you're not commuting, it's a living experience as well as a learning experience. So you want to make sure that there are enough of the things that you enjoy so that you're going to be happy there. That's how you're going to get the most out of the full college experience. And then the learning, is it going to be near things that are required for your major? And then afterwards, is it going to help land you the job that you would like in a career that you would like after college? So now what I would like you to do is to take about 10 to 15 minutes to fill out the major worksheet that's down below this video, and then to try to start coming up with a list of places that you would like to go to college in terms of where in the country, so states or regions that you would like to study in. And I encourage you to also include some stretches. So if you're thinking you want to go on the East Coast, maybe a few Midwestern schools or schools in the middle of the country. Same if you want to go on the West Coast, maybe some Southern schools as well. It's a good idea to include a couple geographic reaches and to try them out. And sometimes that will help if you're going to a school and they say they have students from 49 states and they're looking for that 50th state and that's where you happen to be from. That could help you in the admission. Sometimes schools look at geographic diversity. Thanks for watching this video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.